Interview and Job Search Strategies at Work. Thank you once again for listening to this podcast. If this is your first time, welcome to the podcast. Really appreciate it. This podcast is about helping you get an IT job or a job in that field relative to information technology. Other than that, I do want to talk today about a job that is not necessarily in the IT field, but I think it's worth chatting about. And actually, it's about in working in the movies. So as you probably know, working in the movies, it's glamorized. You have actors and actresses who work 16 hours a day and sometimes very strenuous hours. So they have there's a staff behind that. They have a production team. They have different various types of positions. One particular I'd like to talk to you about is it's called a production assistant. And what a production assistant is, basically, they get minimum wage of, you know, the movie set. So if you can think about it, the production assistant on a movie set, they get paid the lowest, but they have to deal with the most BS, basically, right? So they get, not only do they get the actors and actresses coffee, they do, you know, odds and ends, anything that they need. Maybe they need to park their car. Maybe they need to take out dry cleaning and take dry cleaning for the actor, actress. They need to maybe order food. Maybe they need to go pick up food. Maybe they need to clean out the trailer of the actor or actress. Although they have probably a team that does that, but a production assistant would do that in any case. They're very long hours, so and then you kind of have to have a photographic memory, basically, in order to pull off this position. Basically, what it is there's no, for this position, there's no defined job duties. It's like anything goes. Here you go, just go out and do whatever the actors and actresses need, or whoever the production set, hey, I need you to take care of this, do it, move out. So I did say that it is minimum wage, but you're on this movie set. You could be on the movie set for, you know, long hours. You could be on the movie set for 12 hours a day or longer. And you probably could be, even if you're on location, you could be in another location where you have free food, you have free room and board. So you could really bank up, make a lot of money. You could probably make six figures, even though it's a minimum wage job, based on how many hours you work and the overtime. So the production assistant is like the lowest tier. That's the basic entry point for a movie set, right? And then from there, you have what they call a line producer. I'm sorry, like a production line, like a production line producer, basically, or line producer. Basically, they're in charge of the production assistants. So they handle the staff, the lower than them. The line producers are the managers, basically, of the production assistants and some of the crews, like the key grip, the sound people, the IT people that are there, the catering, make sure that gets done, all that. I mean, that's a very, very strenuous job, and they get usually about, you know, anywhere from 180 to 200K a year. That's a line producer. So the line producer, they basically handle personnel. You know, they don't do too much with the movie itself. The setting up the set. They don't do that. They have people that do that. So they manage the people that do that. Then you have a film producer, and then you have a executive producer. So those, obviously, they're like the production company. They're like basically like, we're producing the film. So they would be in charge of, say, getting the site ready, having location ready, having everything dialed in, everything set up before the movie production starts. Before everything starts, they'd be the ones that they would do that. So one thing you may or may not know, sometimes actors and actresses, they don't get paid. They don't get paid to like the a bunch of money. Usually, the first time they do a movie, usually there's like a set fee, or they get paid per hour. You know, usually like that. How they make their money is on endorsements. They get their money that way, or their image, like pertaining to their image. As you can understand, right? What happens is a lot of these movies, they go out and they film, and the people that make the most money are usually the production company or the directors, you know, or whatever. And if it's, say you're an actor and actress, right? And you make, say, $20 million, right? On a movie, let's just say, right? Well, you have to pay for that home that you live in. So that means, okay, you make $20 million on a movie. So you're looking at probably half, and taxes are a little less, let's say 30%. So you're looking at what, 12, 15, something like that, $15 million. So $15 million has to go towards your other expenses. So you might have a house, so you have to, you don't want to live in a bad area, by the way, in Los Angeles. So you're going to live in a nice area, because obviously you're an actor and actress, and you have to maintain that image. So you're going to most likely have an expensive home, a costly home, a higher priced home, say $2, $3 million, right? So what happens is almost like a cycle where you work on movies to earn money to pay for the lifestyle that you're portraying. Obviously, quite obviously, you know, that they're, I mean, who is going to say something when somebody is on TV? But obviously, they're actors and actresses are people like everybody else. So they obviously have their own things, issues to deal with, right? Like everybody else. And it's not like they can get a real, you know, it's not like they can get a normal job, basically, right? I mean, if they've been an actor and actress for how many years and they're in a movie, and then they go back and, you know, try to get a job. So like almost like a child actors, right? You've probably seen child actors try to get a real job somewhere else. And it's almost, it's not difficult, but it's a little like, well, hey, you were in the movies, why are you doing this, right? Because a lot of people don't understand how that whole thing works. Something else also, right? If you're an actor and actress and you're on, say, a TV show that is going for, say, 3-5 seasons, right? Something like that. What happens is, You have to maintain the same weight. You have to maintain the same weight, the same look, if you will. So you're under obligation. You're under contract, basically, to do that. So what happens is sometimes they hire personal trainers, or they hire whoever to keep them, say, within a certain weight range. Maybe it's like 10 pounds or 15 pounds that the company wants them in, the movie company wants them to be in. So they have to maintain that. So you can imagine how stressful that is for a 3-year period. So on, for instance, on a TV show called, it's called Smallville, right? So on Smallville, some of the actors and actresses, they had, you know, literally work like 12, 16 hours a day, and they would go home and go to sleep and then do it all over again. They basically didn't have a life. And then that show ran for like 10 years. So, just imagine the toll it takes. You know, obviously they have an off season, right, where they don't film. Anyway, so let's talk IT, right, by the way. So if you're an IT person and you get a job with, movie company, basically, you know, you're going to be, like, your bandwidth is going to be crazy fast. The infrastructure is going to be, like, on point, basically, right? Basically, everything, I mean, they do it, I mean, you can imagine, right, a movie. It's like a $100 million movie, let's say, right, or whatever. They're going to have the best of the best for internet, for infrastructure, for IT hardware, software. They're going to have the best of the best. And so all your job is to go in and just make it work, or assist it as needed. Maybe pull cables, plug in switches or routers, run extensions, access points, whatever, Wi-Fi, wireless points, wireless access points, whatnot. Same thing holds true for an IT person. You're on site usually. You don't usually, if you're, as I was saying, some of the IT people, usually they don't stay, unless it's like a shoot that's off in the middle of somewhere, and they have to have an offsite basically. So the whole production company has to go out there and stay for, you know, a week at a time or whatever. Then you would, as an IT person, then you would make extra money, like overtime basically, because you're there. And, you know, free food and all that stuff, obviously, right? So if you're an IT person, you definitely could save a lot of money not having a food expense, and you get like a cheap apartment with coworkers or whatever. So I'd like to thank everybody for listening to this podcast, and have a great day.